Thank you for joining Insight with Insiders. I'm Julianne Bittner. Besides my high energy, intestinal fortitude, I'm an extremely passionate person who loves to empower staffing owners through education, resource, and expertise. It's why I started this podcast series, Insight with Insiders. I wanted to bring industry experts to the table to discuss issues, challenging, and emerging trends in the staffing industry. Today, I've asked Lindsay Stanton to join me. Lindsay is president and board member of Digi-Me, a video technology company for talent acquisition that helps organizations with a new dimension to their job and employment branding messaging. In her time with the company, Lindsay has facilitated relationships with many partners, including the largest recruitment advertising agencies, global recruitment process outsourcers, and staffing firms. These partnerships magnify the organization's reach into the global Fortune 1000, providing an effective and innovative solution to the largest global employers, including Kelly OCG, Adecco, TrueBlue, USG Corporation, and Federal Express, just to name a few. A subject matter expert on the use of video technology as a recruitment tool, Lindsay works closely with industry leaders, creating new and better ways to connect jobs and job seekers. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Lindsay Stanton of Digi-Me. Welcome, Lindsay, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm excited about the show.
That's great. So recently you were featured as a presenter of our monthly webinar series, and the topic you spoke about was amplify your recruiting efforts by riding the digital wave. And it was outstanding. I had to listen to it twice. I had lots of notes from it. So I think we're going to dig into it a little bit today with our viewers. So if you don't mind.
Great.
One of the things that came out really clear for me is your passion about what you do. I mean, it's very clear you love what you do. Why is it?
Well, I think partially being able to help build something. So my husband and I actually, I helped launch the company with him. He built the company and launched it about 6 months before I joined the organization. And he unfortunately passed away last year. And so I feel like I'm carrying the torch now for the both of us. But that advancement of technology and improvement of the space and really kind of continuing to push the ball downfield and give organizations a fair shake at finding the right talent was really important to us around the launch and the continual renewal of technology. Technology can really be such a game changer in the way that companies recruit and the data that they're presented with and making educational choices around their business and strategy. So I am very passionate about it. I think the fact that I've had the opportunity to work with so many large associations like the American Staffing Association in the space definitely helps charge me up too. I have the pleasure of sitting on the Women in Leadership Council for ASA. And so, you know, that is definitely something that helps keep me passionate too.
Sorry to hear about your husband, but what a great tribute to him for you to continue this business and launching it so much further into the staffing arena and other businesses. I was surprised that after really listening to the webinar, businesses like our own, my own, we can incorporate these trends of video technology. So I want to dig into that. How difficult is it to implement the process? I was a little scared of it at the beginning, even doing this, a podcast, when the team said, let's do these back, I don't know, 6-7 months ago. I'm like, really? I'm not experienced at that. So how difficult is implementing a video, this process?
Yeah, that's a great question. And definitely one we get asked a lot. I think a lot of people are scared of video, although I think the pandemic kind of forced people in a way to be exposed to video and probably in a way they've never been exposed to it before, pre-Zoom, when we were Zoom naive, right?
Exactly.
But it does not have to be scary. And it does not even have to involve you or your face. So that's one thing that actually our clients get really excited about because it can be as simple as us getting a feed of text job descriptions. And we have automated technology that creates videos around the job postings within less than 48 hours and kicks them out. We have a heavily branded custom solution that involves our production team. Clients have the option through our live dashboard to create video content with their recruiters or sourcers, but I would definitely say that's more the exception than the rule. Our clients that leverage that type of solution typically tend to be the ones recruiting for very difficult kind of one-off roles where they'll want a recruiter introducing the concept of the job and kind of giving a high touch introduction. And then it goes into the professionally produced video. But literally we can create a video with something as simple as just the written job description and the client's logo. It does not have to be complicated. It can be as short as 48 hour turnaround. If it's custom, it's usually about a week, but it does not have to be a long involved process by any means. And we pretty much do all the lifting for the clients. So we keep it painless.
Okay, very good. Is this video geared to one type of job category, one sector of the industry, or is it for all industries?
Yeah, so typically they are going to be job specific. We definitely find that it impacts, significantly negatively impacts conversion if you get too generic with it, because then the candidates aren't sure, or are you actually hiring for the position that they'd be interested in? Is it in a market they'd be wanting to work in? So what we typically do is we'll create the video job around the position itself. Mm-hmm. And then we call it the skin of the video, but basically the text that surrounds the video ad will specify the location, and the apply button that's on our patented player will link to the actual application page for that location. So then the candidate has the confidence that you're actually hiring in their market. The other benefit that gives you is from an SEO perspective, then you're pulling people specific to that job and specific to that location. And since social is so important, we see a really tight link with location and social as well. Like the more specific you can be about hiring market, the more your videos get shared out in social groups that are very much market driven. We do help clients with more branding type of content, but that's a different type of video than on the job specific side. On the job specific side, there's some rules of the trade. You don't want to get too long. That's like one of the big ones. 60 seconds or less. Like some of our clients that are in the retail or hospitality sector, they can even squeeze it down to 30 seconds. But we track the duration the candidate views a video, and it's typically right around that 57 to 60 second-ish mark. So it does, it's usually when the client's logo pops on the screen is when they're then clicking through to the call to action. So they will stay on the whole time, and they will be, stay engaged. You can keep them a little bit longer if you're kind of doing a little bit deeper dive into your company or culture. Then they typically will stay on for like around the 2 minute mark. A lot of times we're helping clients, especially on the enterprise side, as you can probably imagine, like condense down content. Like they might hand us a 30 minute video that their marketing team developed that they thought somebody was going to watch other than them.
Right.
And they aren't. Right. So we help like shrink it into, a digestible amount of content so that we can link it to their jobs too.
I was surprised to hear that, you had spoke about the retention, about how your videos, the viewer, their ability to retain information, like the requirements, is better. Can you explain that a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it hits on probably one of the biggest frustrations that recruiters have, and that they're getting candidates that are not qualified, don't have the right mix of experience, license, et cetera. And the nice thing about video is you basically are forcing the candidate to understand what your requirements are, whether it's lifting a certain amount or whatever it might be. candidates will learn and retain over 70% more when they watch and listen to a video versus, I always say reading in air quotes, because I feel like people don't read anything anymore. I mean, I even catch myself doing it. Like if I see an email on my phone, I'm like, oh my God, this is so long. And I get to my computer and it's really only a paragraph long email. So I think, you know, it's the same thing for our job seekers, especially right now when they're very much in the driver's seat. So we need to keep it, you know, short, digestible content, but we can control how much of that content they absorb when they watch a video versus reading the text.
Mm-hmm. Interesting that you guys are able to research and find out time of day better for job posting, right? And yeah. Quality. So can you explain that a little bit more?
Yeah, absolutely. So we, part of our patented video player is the tracking on not only the execution of the apply button and the social share icon, but we also track the behavior of the candidates. So where, when, how they're sharing, viewing, and applying for the jobs. And we certainly see some kind of across the board trends. But then they'll get, you know, then it gets into, there's definitely some data that's specific to certain job titles and certain markets. And it's interesting, some of the trends that we see develop, but typically across the board, Tuesdays and Thursdays tend to be the best days of the week to release your jobs to get the highest apply conversion. And then interestingly enough, we definitely see that during the workday, generally during like the mid to late afternoon, is the best conversion for applies as far as time of day. So people are looking for jobs while they're at their job. That's the long and short of it. Without a doubt, the worst performing pretty much across all job types and all job locations is going to be the weekend. So you definitely don't want to post your jobs on the weekend. You're going to definitely see, you know, a decreased conversion if you do that. So we, like I said, we do track based on the client, you know, specific job and location, but we also see some, you know, kind of across the board trends, whether you're hiring a warehouse worker or you're hiring, you know, an advanced level engineer. We see that, you know, pretty consistently.
Interesting. I would have thought weekends would have been strong. You would have thought.
You know, and we hear that a lot from clients and a lot of people, they're very, you know, have been in the industry forever. But yeah, no, people want to have fun on the weekend. Right. I always think like my theory behind it is that Tuesday is like they put up with their boss on Monday and they're super frustrated. And that's when they're thinking about making a move. And Thursday is like, you know, they're at the end of their work week and they just can't take it anymore. So, to me, like those 2 days actually do make sense if you kind of, when you're kind of thinking from the mindset of a job seeker.
Okay. What is, you talk a little bit about social link and brand story. I was trying to follow that in the webinar and it was interesting to me. And I think let's have you explain that a little bit more.
Yeah, absolutely. So, social, I mean, I talk about social a lot because it is just, I continually see what a huge impact it has for our clients, especially now as organizations are just trying to figure out where they can reach people, trying to tap into new talent pools. And the nice thing about the data behind our video player is it kind of pulls the clients in the right direction. And generally that is social. So we see that across the board, again, all job types, all job levels, social outperforms and outpaces everything else. And when I talk about social, I'm not talking about paid campaigns. I'm talking about organic activity. So the nice thing about our patented player is the candidates themselves can push the messaging out. So they can share our client's video job ad on a Facebook group, on Twitter, on LinkedIn, no matter, you know, wherever. And then we're tracking all that. So we know where and when it's been shared and what that led to for the customer. And usually, so on the apply side, for instance, the social sharing is typically driving about 60% of the applicant flow. So what's nice is just by including the videos in their, you know, normal sourcing strategy, that kind of kickstarts the SEO, getting the word out there, and then results in social sharing. But the candidates end up doing a lot of the work. And it's a twofold benefit because obviously it's a free resource and the data is going to help them see where they should be spending their time. Cause I know social in and of itself can be a little bit daunting, you know, where do you focus your time and efforts? So the data will help pull them the right direction. But in addition to that, it's an awesome third party validator of your brand and your messaging, because now you've got your candidates as your advocates, you know, sharing your information about your position openings, your company, your brand. And that's pretty awesome.
Right, right. Well, what I got out of it was even an organization, we use staffing companies, the positions to hire for our positions. So why not create a video, yes, for the position, but also because we're hiring on a professional level, is give a 2-minute video of the culture of what they're going to expect when they walk in the front door.
Yeah.
So because all of our interviews are done video now, right now,
yeah.
Do a couple, you know, walk in the front door, see the receptionist who greets you, the culture, the environment, what it looks like, a few of the employees. So you kind of see the culture, meet a manager or two, and it can be very low key, just casual, again, under 2 minutes. To give them the experience that they won't get from an interview.
Exactly. Yeah. They feel like they know you, and that's going to help convince them to, you know, make a move, which is super important right now. And like, I know with our clients in staffing, for example, they sometimes candidates don't really realize what their role in the process is, and they don't understand that they're, you know, going to be an advocate on their behalf. So showing and telling that story is really important too, and it's part of their brand. So even though they might be working on, you know, an end customer's behalf, they can really develop that rapport and relationship with the candidate through, you know, building great video content that shows kind of how they help advocate for the candidate throughout the process, which is really important. And then from a brand perspective, I mean, as you, you know, you kind of hit the nail on the head, like you have to, you're selling them on why think about making a change, you know, ultimately at the end of the day, why are they going to think about leaving where they're at now to come work for you? So sometimes it's the littlest details that make people feel the most comfortable and confident in their decision of making a move. So showcasing those little things, whether it's, you know, the charity that you guys associate with, or, you know, something special about your work environment, something fun that you guys do, you know, as an organization together, things like that, that, you know, can be missed, lost, certainly in text, that translate really well to video and kind of pull people in and sell your story versus, you know, just your company itself.
And I think as a staffing owner or salesperson, you can go to your customer and say, we would like to do this, be partnered with you and feature these videos for you as we're trying to get candidates in the door for you. It's going to help sell that position. So
yeah, absolutely.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And as you can probably imagine, we're helping our clients extensively now with including in their video messaging, diversity and inclusion, and even military recruiting efforts as they, again, you know, are looking to deepen the talent pool that they're reaching. And there's no better way to do that than through video, because if you're trying to reach a certain audience, showing them in your video and showing them as part of your organization is a pretty easy way to do that.
Right, exactly. So it's kind of, we're leading down this path is, what have you seen the pandemic? What happened, the pandemic changed in the recruiting, in the trends with the recruitment?
Yeah, I mean, I think everything's moving to digital, right? I mean, it did kind of force people to be comfortable being remote, being virtual, and with that, you know, creating kind of still having that layer of personalization required video and being digital. So, you know, we've seen huge swings towards digital in all aspects, not just on the video job side and on the branding side, but like with virtual events. And, you know, we're helping a lot of clients with video enabled virtual career fairs because they are trying to hire fast. I mean, it's like when the light switch got flipped fast. So now we're all kind of trying to catch up. And video can be a very quick, easy way to, you know, help fill with high volume, especially with the social sharing on the automated side. So I think some of the things that I've seen are definitely continuing the direction of automation as well as digital technology for sure. And organizations trying to figure out, okay, where, you know, we've tapped all of our normal resources. What else can we do? You know, they're forced to be more innovative. And in some ways it kind of reminds me, so we launched the business in 2008, which was an interesting time to launch a company, yeah, as you can imagine. But in a lot of ways, I see the same types of focus of attention right now during the ramp as we did during that downturn. And that is because data is the name of the game. So in both scenarios, organizations were very focused around ROI and where they're actually getting conversion. We're definitely seeing the same thing today, because as they look to expand reach, they have to know that what they're doing is going to work. It's going to fill their clients' jobs. And that, you know, data-driven focus, that need to expand their reach, personalize their touch, but still comes back to the data and what's the data telling them and where is it pulling them?
Mm-hmm. Well, recently we've had some changes across the United States and in certain states with the federal unemployment being, you know, the states are saying, you know what, we're not going to supplement it, which on the flip side, I'm hearing from clients, phones are ringing, ghosting has stopped. So with digital, how I'm bringing this into the whole digital is, you know, you want to be in the forefront of those candidates. You want to be the first ones those candidates reach out to. So, I mean, what do you say to staffing companies today? They go, hey, you want those candidates to call you first.
How do you exactly? And that's, I mean, that's where the SEO and social plays such a huge role, because when people are typing in keywords, you don't have to be a huge player, you know, a household recognized name. I mean, not that most candidates even necessarily know the big guys that we know in the industry, they might not even know who they are. But as long as you're showing up when they're doing a search, you know, if they're looking, as long as you're showing up and they're able to see something, and to your point about doing kind of the more branding video, if they see a video and they feel comfortable with you, they're going to call you over your competitor.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So what's the best advice you can give employers today that say, I can't seem to find any job seekers? Where are they?
Social. I mean, the social groups, like the Facebook groups and so it's interesting. Facebook groups tend to be one of the higher converting sources for our clients, especially, you know, on the candidate-driven sharing side. But sites like Twitter and using Twitter hashtags have their purpose, because where they might not necessarily lead to conversion, they lead to sharing. So, and that leads to conversion. So I always tell clients, you know, don't skip out on Twitter, because those hashtags do, you know, create a purpose for you, and ultimately you will get conversion. But the talent's out there. It's just a matter of finding it and having the data to show you where you need to go back to. And we see a lot of our customers kind of piggybacking that data and sending their recruiters into specific groups and, communities to reach talent that the data is showing them, you know, is out there. So it's possible, even in today's interesting hiring climate, to find the right people and to do it quickly. I mean, we're helping companies ramp pretty fast. So it is definitely possible. You just have to have the right information to, you know, point you the right direction.
Have you seen any companies that, you know, Facebook, we use LinkedIn, people use Twitter, a little bit on Instagram. I don't see a lot of people using Instagram. I do see some. How about TikTok? Have they started using
TikTok? We're starting to see clients use that. It'll be interesting, though. I know, kind of to your point, people talked about Instagram, and I feel like it didn't really quite get the adoption that people were expecting. So I'm interested to see where the data shows us, you know, as far as the trends on TikTok go. Because sometimes, you know, it translates strong to like reach the candidates where they're already going just for social content. Other times, like, they obviously are just very focused on like the fun content only. So it'll be interesting to see what the data story tells us around that.
Right. Instagram seems to me a great source for companies to sell their company, the culture, who
yeah.
they are, the, if they're hiring internally, but right. not to seek those candidates for staffing.
Right.
So, you know, because it's really selling your brand of who you are as a company.
Yeah.
And I haven't seen it done really well yet for getting candidates in. But it,
right.
That could be interesting, you know, if you can do, figure out a way to do it in a creative environment like TikTok.
It'll be right. Well, and I think to your point, like, there's always benefit in like hitting people over and over again with your message, even if they're just going on there for quick kind of instant gratification content. If they're seeing consistency of your messaging, maybe it's a super short video for TikTok and Instagram, and then a more comprehensive, you know, video job description or, you know, cultural content on like a Facebook. But as long as there's consistency in the messaging and you're kind of hitting them everywhere they're going, it's like, then they're like, oh, okay, maybe I should, you know, check out this company.
Mm-hmm. Great. Well, in closing, what else, any other advice you can give our listeners today?
I mean, definitely everything is data driven. I'm very focused and very interested to see how automation continues to progress in our industry. It's a heavy focus for me personally with our organization. I think it's just really important. Everybody's very focused on efficiency and workflow. So I think that's going to be something that we continue to see with a lot of vendors in this space, a lot of providers and organizations just really focusing on automation and how to be more efficient leveraging it.
Great. And I really encourage our listeners today to go back out also and listen to the webinar that you did recently. It's out on our website at tricom.com under our newsletters and webinars. You'll see Amplify Your Recruiting Efforts by Riding the Digital Wave. It was just done this last May, just a couple weeks ago. So please go out there and listen to it, because I think you have some great information in there that we didn't cover all of it today, but I think we did dig into a few other items that you cover in your webinar, so we can get a little bit more expansive understanding of it. This was great information. I look forward to using video content in our recruiting process, and even just using video content and understanding who we are as an organization to get businesses out there to understand more about who you are as a business. Is
yeah.
I think it also helps sells your business, right?
Absolutely. So
I think we all got to get comfortable with it, because that's where we're going.
Indeed.
Well, thank you very much for your time, Lindsay. This was great. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me. I really enjoyed it.
You take care, and we'll see you soon at the next conference, I hope.
Okay. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.